bright color, to be lustrously red or brilliant. And he's talking about cheeks. When it comes to cheeks, he says to exhibit a healthy, warm, a ruddy kind of reddish color, to become or feel very warm or hot, to show emotion or elation, to glow with pride. Glow is what happens when a parent attends the graduation ceremony of their first son.
Amen.
Or first daughter.
Amen.
And they're just glowing with pride.
Amen.
They're just looking. They are quiet, but everybody seeing that parent knows this parent is glowing.
Amen.
They can tell that their child is one of the children being awarded today. They are glowing. Glow is what the parents feels when they are walking, a father, for example, feels when he's walking up the aisle, handing his wife and his child with him. Holy Spirit. Handing his child to another man for life. He glows with pride. And when a man doesn't feel that way, he obviously himself is not godly. So therefore, he's afraid of so many things that people do in marriage, and is expecting that it may happen to his own daughter. But when he is godly himself, he has done his part as a father, and the child has not gone to the same way he's trying to marry, all he can see is the glow of God. He knows that that day is another good day. It's not a day to be afraid. It's not a day to be listening to all these dangerous people who think they have opinion about marriage and what will happen. Glow is what you and I get. And what we do and what we be when we have our God. Amen? In the Word of God, the book of Proverbs tells us in chapter 3, verses 7 and 8, that we should, he said, don't assume that you know it all. So humble yourself. Don't think you've got it all covered. Always go to God. And when you do that, when you run to God, that's what it says in Proverbs 3, verse 7. When you run to God, or you run from evil, which is the same. When you run from evil, you are running to God. When you run to God, you are running from evil. So when you run to God, when you run from evil, the results you get is that your body will glow with health.
Amen.
In another translation, it says your body will glow with health. That is, you'll be healthy. Many people are stressed because they are not glowing from inside. Too many weights, too many concerns, too many assumptions. This is what they mean by just looking at me. I know what they mean. What, how do you know what they mean? You're piling everybody's worry, everybody's problem, and you're owning it, so there's no room to glow. So people are looking at you in the wedding ceremony where everybody's happy. They are even asking, are you okay? Because you are not glowing, and it's bothering them. They put you in a table of 10, it's a round table, so you don't get to hide your face. And 9 of them are glowing, and they are wondering. It's almost like they can't tell you that you don't belong to this table, but the Christianese way is they now decided to ask, are you okay? That will not be your portion.
Amen.
You will glow.
Amen.
Your body will glow with health. Your very bones will vibrate with life.
Amen.
When your bone vibrates with life, you wake up every day, you're not carrying all the problems of the world on your shoulder. Some people, they got carried away because of Brexit. Brexit today, Brexit tomorrow. Is Britain still not? Today, it's still existing. The politicians are doing their job, you do yours. Stay focused on God. Run to God, run from evil. Another thing we can do is in Proverbs 4, verse 18. This is another version I'm reading, because we know the King James Version. It says, the ways of right living people glow with light.
Amen.
If you want to glow, you live right.
Amen.
How do you live right? You live according to the word of God, not according to your uncle. Not according to your mom or dad, according to the word of God, because they also have to do the same. So you live right. When you live right, you glow with light. It just happens. Nobody can do anything about it. They can't cover it up. When you are living right, you will glow. You'll be wondering why people, how could they tell that you are blessed? Yes, it's because you are glowing. It's very spiritual. So that's what you have to do. You live right, so you can glow. And the results will be that the longer you live, the brighter you shine.
Amen.
That's what the Bible was saying. King James said, it shines brighter and brighter until a perfect day.
Amen.
The longer you live, the brighter you shine.
Amen.
As a father, you are shining brighter.
Amen.
As a mother, you are shining brighter.
Amen.
As a young adult, you are shining brighter.
Amen.
By the time you are a teenager and you are not a young adult, you are shining brighter.
Amen.
When you say you are grown, we will listen to you and we will be nodding. I agree with you because we know that you are right. You are shining brighter and brighter.
Amen.
From when you were young.
Amen.
This morning I was looking around and I realized that most of the time our teenagers come earlier than the adults for stewardship, for setting up the house of God. They come earlier than the adults. We thank God that we've been honoring them from the beginning. They are actually serving seriously. And look at them, you know, they're sorting things out. That is wonderful. Wonderful in regarding them. It's more wonderful when the adults also come on time, amen? But we're talking about glowing. Another thing we can read in Isaiah 58 verse 10. If you are generous with the hungry, and you start giving yourselves to the down and out, you are very helpful. You are very generous. You always do that. You look for opportunities. You can see today, yesterday, many times, many families, individuals, they've always done things behind the scenes. Many people don't know. We don't announce it. They're consistently doing it. It's a member, a family that blessed the church with this holding. It's a family that blessed us with these two wonderful chairs that look like my senior pastor's chair in the main church. The day the person blessed us, I said, wow, we are in a humble place, but this feels like prayer city. Because when I sit in prayer city, it's not as nice as that. You know? So that means in the spirit of that person, they don't see a small place. They don't see a community or you can just treat anyhow. They see a house of God. Which means that is how God will see them too. So they are glowing from inside. Because if you glow from inside, you will think about your house, your pastor, your members, and you just do as occasion demands. If you are generous with the hungry, and you start giving yourself to the down and out, the result is that your lives will begin to glow in darkness. Your shadow lives will be burned in sunlight. The things that have clouded your life, that didn't allow your glory to come out. Because you are glowing by doing these wonderful things, then that glow will come out and will begin to remove all the things that are shadowing the light of God that is in you. Amen?
Amen.
So I want to encourage everybody here, glow. Not only this week, but forever. Glow.
Amen.
But we can see the glowing starts from inside. Yeah? Glow in dark. Glow in light. And when you do such, all things will look lovely and you will look lovely. Amen?
Amen.
In Daniel 12 verse 3, the Message translation says, men and women who have lived wisely and well, they will shine brilliantly. You will shine brilliantly.
Amen.
You will glow brilliantly.
Amen.
They will shine like the cloudless, star-strewn night skies. And what will happen is if you also put others on the right path, that's why we say every day, lead people to Christ. Say something that is God. It's not about you alone. You have to be leading others to Christ, converting them to Christ. If you are a faithful person in your church, teach others to be faithful. If you are someone who is committed to one church, then teach others to be committed to one church. If you are faithful in seeing beneath, just I like my pastor, I love my pastor, and you don't love me. If you are someone who is bigger than that, and you just love Christ, so you just stay where you are and you correct any evil, but you stay where you are, then you teach your friends the same.
Amen.
You'll find that all of you will become faithful members of the church where you say you are pastors. Some people are pastors, but they are never there with the pastor. They are everywhere. Today's generation, especially the young generation, need to be taught to be faithful. That faithfulness is really tested when you are in one church. And those who don't listen to that good advice, based on the word of God, they learn it later. They still learn it, but it comes at a cost for refusing to learn it early. Everything everybody requires for growth is in where you are, unless it wasn't God that led you there. But God is not an author of confusion.
Amen.
So you want to glow, you glow from inside out by staying connected to God, staying connected to His word, stay connected to his statutes. Stay connected to his commandments.
Amen.
When you do that, you will glow.
Amen.
And nobody will be able to cover your glow.
Amen.
You will glow everywhere you go.
Amen.
You will glow at work.
Amen.
You will glow in strange places.
Amen.
You will glow in dark places.
Amen.
You will glow even in light places.
Amen.
Because the glow of God is in you.
Amen.
And it will remain forever and ever.
Amen.
When you glow inwardly, you will glow outwardly.
Amen.
So focus on the inward part. The outward part will take care of itself.
Amen.
So make sure that you're focusing on glowing from inside. Amen. And without the word of God, where is that glowing coming from? The Bible says his word is a light unto our path and a lamp unto our feet. So if you want to glow, you go to the word of God. And I'm telling you by the grace of God upon my life that the word of God will cause you to glow.
Amen.
That is why we want all our children to have Bibles. That's why we want our parents to be a blessing. You can't not buy a Bible for your child and you say you love the child. There's no other love that you can love your child more than the love of Christ. That's the best, that's the only love that really is bigger. It's the biggest. And is the deepest and the richest. So I pray in the name of Jesus, just as the word says in Jeremiah 13:16, that your lives will glow bright before God. And that even when it's time for God to turn out the lights on that last day, your light will shine from inside. And you'll be among those who will reign with Christ. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord.